Very good morning to one and all. Myself Swati, working as an assistant professor in the department of EC of St. Martin's Engineering College. I am leading the subject is Signals and Systems. In these signals and systems, we have to learn the 5 units. In these 5, what are the 5 units in the signals and systems? The first unit is the signal analysis. Second unit is the Fourier series and Fourier transform. Third unit is the linear time invariant system. And the fourth unit is the jet transform. And fifth unit is the sampling theorem. In this video, we have to learn about the first unit, that is signal analysis. In this signal analysis, what is the classification of the signal? What is the classification of the system? What are the elementary signals? Okay. By using this first unit, we have to learn the remaining 4 units. Okay. First of all, before going to start the first unit, we have to learn the first of all what is signal and what is system. Okay. Coming to the signal. What is signal? Signal is a physical phenomena which is intended to convey the information. Okay. Signal is in the form of function of time. Okay. Signal it is intended to convey the information. So it will be in the function of time. Okay. This signal, best example of this signal is the electric voltage or current. The best example is human speech. Okay. The human speech. Whatever we are talking, that signal will be converted. It will convey the information. This is the best example for signal. Okay. Human voice or human speech. Human speech and electric voltage or current, and the resistor is also a example of the signal. Electric voltage or current. Okay, this is the example of signal. We have to represent in the mathematical representation. In the signals will be represented in the mathematical form. The example of the signal is. The signal will be represented by the x of t. It will be represented in mathematical form. This is the example for the signal. We have to represent the signal in the x axis is the t. This is the independent variable x of t. In this x, this is the dependent variable. This is the dependent variable. Okay, t is the independent variable here. T is the independent variable. Okay, coming to the signal. Signal is a combination of one or more independent variable. Okay, it consisting of one or more independent variables. So, it consisting of one independent variable means it will be called as one dimensional function. Okay, it consisting of one independent variable. It consisting of one independent variable means that function is called as one dimensional function. Okay, the signal which consisting of two independent variable. The signal which consisting of two independent variables means that function is called as the two-dimensional function. That function is called as two-dimensional function. Okay, this is all about the signal. Signal is a function of time which is intended to convey the information. The signal will consisting of one independent variable means it's called as one dimensional function. Signal will consisting of two independent variable means it called as two dimensional function. Let's we'll discuss about the what is system. Whatever the signal we are giving, that will be processed in the system and it will produce the output. That is called as system. Okay. System. Already we learned about the signal. Now let us discuss about the system. System is a combination of one or more devices. It is a combination of one or more devices. It will be processed by the signal. Whatever the information we are producing the signal, that information will be processed in the system. Okay, system is a combination of one or more devices. It will be processed by the signal and produce the output. Okay, the whatever the input signal we are giving to the system, that input is called as the excitation. Excitation. So whatever the input we are giving to the system is called as excitation. Whatever the output coming from the system is called as the resolution. Whatever the output coming from the system is called as the resolution. This is about the system. What is the relation between the signal and system? Signal will be processed by the system. This is the phenomena about the signals and system. Coming to the classification of the signals and system, the based upon their nature and characteristics. Based upon the signals and systems will be classified into two types. Based upon what are those two types? Continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Okay, how we can classify this continuous time signal and the discrete time signal based upon their nature and characteristics. Based upon the nature and characteristics, the signal will be classified into two types. Okay, what are those two types? The continuous time signal and the discrete time signal. Coming to the continuous time signal, the signal which is defined every instant of time. Okay, the signal will be defined. And coming to the first, we learn about the continuous time signal. Coming to the continuous time signal, the continuous time signal will be defined as the signal will be defined for every instant of time is called as the continuous time signal. In these continuous time signal, the both amplitude and time, the both amplitude and time will be continuous manner. Okay, coming to the discrete time signal, it will be the discrete time signal will be defined as the only discrete time intervals. The signal will be defined at only discrete time intervals at the time instant of t. Okay, the best example, the continuous time signals is also called as the analog signals. Analog signals. This will, the continuous time signals are also called as the analog signals. Discrete time signals are also called as the digital signals. Okay, this signal, digital signals will be in the number form, that will be denoted by digital letters are the 0 and 1. Okay, coming to the continuous time signal, this signal will be continuous in the instant of every instant of time. This will be in the discrete time intervals. The signal will be defined at discrete time intervals of time. Okay, coming to the continuous time signal, this is the example for this. The continuous time signal will be denoted by the letter x of t. And the discrete time signal will be denoted by the letter x of m. Here x is the dependent variable. Here x is the dependent variable. T is the independent variable. T is the independent variable. In the discrete time signal, x is the dependent and n is the independent variable. Here n will be called as the integer. Here t is the, t equals to time. Here n is the integer. Here n is the integer. So coming to the example of the continuous time signal, its continuous time signal is also called as analog signal. The example of this continuous time signal is the this one. Or any sinusoidal wave or square wave, the signals will be in the continuous manner. Okay, the signal will be continued. The signal will be continued. X-axis will be denoted by the letter time t, and the y-axis will be denoted by the letter x of t. X-axis will be represented in the dependent variable, y-axis will be represented in the independent variable. Okay, coming to the discrete time signal. Okay, the example for the discrete time signal, it will be defined, the discrete time signal will be defined at only discrete time intervals. Okay, we have to take this signal only. This signal will be in the defined at only discrete time intervals. So in the discrete time signal, it will be represented by the letter x. X will be the x of n. This is the n here. Okay, so x of n here, what is that? X is the dependent variable. Here x is the dependent variable in the discrete time signal. What is the independent variable here? N. N is the integer here. integer and this is the independent variable. Okay, and the discrete time signal is also called as the digital signals. The digital signals will be how to represent in the number form, that is zeros and ones. Okay, this is all about the continuous time signal and the discrete time signal. This is the example for the continuous time signal. This is the example for the discrete time signal. Okay, based upon this, both continuous time signals and discrete time signals are again classified. The continuous time, based upon this continuous time signals and discrete time signals are again classified into 5 types. What are those 5 types? Means periodic signal and the non-periodic signal. Periodic and the non-periodic signal. Periodic signal and the non-periodic signal. Okay. Next one is the even and odd signal. Even and odd signal. Okay, third one is the deterministic and the random signal. Deterministic and the random signal. And fourth one is the real and complex signal. Real and complex signal. And fifth one is the energy and power signal. Energy and power signal. Okay, this is the based upon the continuous and discrete time signal. Again, the signals will be classified. Though again, the signals will be classified into 5 types: periodic and non-periodic, even and odd signal, deterministic and random signal, real and complex signal, energy and power signal. First, we will discuss about the periodic and the non-periodic signal. Periodic and the non-periodic signal. Okay, signal is said to be periodic, means it is the signal will be continuous repeatedly at the regular time interval. The signal will be repeated at every time interval t. Okay, how to, the best example of the periodic signal is the sine wave, triangular wave. Okay, so we have to take sine wave. Okay, the signal is said to be periodic. Okay, the signal is periodic, means the signal is said to be periodic. The it will repeat the cycle at every instant of time t. This total time period will be indicated by the t. The when we are saying the signal is said to be periodic. Periodic means the signal will be repeated at every time interval of t. This type of signal is called as the periodic signal. Okay, now the periodic signals we have to represent in the mathematical expression form. Okay, this is about the periodic signal. We have to represent the periodic and non-periodic in both continuous time signal and the discrete time signal. Okay, this is the continuous time signal form. We have to represent this periodic signal in the discrete time signal manner. Okay, coming to the discrete time signal, the periodic signal we have to represent the every time interval. It will repeat the regular time interval with instant of time. The cycle will be repeated. Okay, again the cycle will be repeated like this. Okay, this phenomena is called as periodic signal. Periodic signal in the continuous time signal and periodic signal in the discrete time signal. In this, okay, this is the periodic signal in the discrete time signal. This is about the periodic signal. Again, the cycle will be repeated. So here it will be represented by the letter n, and here the letter x of n, here x axis will be denoted by the n. Here x of t and the time interval is the t. This is about the periodic signal. Non-periodic signal will be the x of t equals to satisfy the condition x of t plus t for all t. This is about the periodic signal. Okay, this is the condition for the periodic. Non-periodic means this condition is not satisfied. Okay, this condition is not satisfied means the signal will be not repeated. Okay, the signal will be not repeated in this condition is called as non-periodic signal. Okay, periodic signal means cycle will be repeated at every instant of time interval t. In the non-periodic means the signal will be not repeated. This is called as the non-periodic signal. And in the next lecture we have to discuss about remaining signals. Thank you.